Victorians are being urged to name the worst roads in the state in a move to pressure the government to fix them. It's a campaign led by the state opposition. But leader Matthew Guy and his crew have stopped short of committing to fixing the roads themselves if they win power in November.
Rodney Brown has been riding motorcycles for most of his life. Last month he had a crash that could have ended it.
And I hit this motorcycle killer. That's the only word to describe it.
Rod hit this patch on Anarchy Road at Moorabool on the outskirts of Geelong.
I hit this coming up over a rise at 100k an hour. My bike went airborne.
He's written to Roads Minister Ben Carroll to fix it, but there's been no response.
We're working through Rodney Brown's correspondence.
They want to build rail tunnels to the eastern suburbs, which no one had asked for, but the country roads that everyone is asking to be fixed, the Andrews government does nothing.
The opposition has launched a campaign asking Victorians to dob in dodgy roads online at vicsworstroads.vote.
Where they're seeing potholes, where they're seeing crumbling roads, where they're seeing cracking that just simply isn't being maintained.
After 3 months, the list will go to the Roads Minister, but the opposition has stopped short of committing to fund the upgrades itself if elected.
Well, they will run online websites. We'll get on with the job of investing and rebuilding Victoria's road network.
The RACV has already compiled its list of the worst roads in the state. Among its top 10 are parts of the Prince's Highway in Gippsland, the infamous Black Spur and the Warburton Highway in the Yarra Ranges, and Coolart Road among a host of others on Mornington Peninsula.
There's no estimate on how much it will cost to fix all of these roads, but the opposition concedes it could run into the billions.
We know that the Andrews government has cut the roads maintenance budget by 25%.
We've invested more than $700 million every year under our government.
Patrick Murrell for 10 News First.